There's just massive demand for data centers. And so one thing that we can control is what they call behind the meter power generation. So that is where we basically, you know, control our destiny. And that's what we're doing.
Welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Will Gray. He is the CEO of New Era Energy and Digital. And Will, it's great to see you again. How are you?
Doing well, Steve. Yourself?
I'm doing very well. Thanks very much. Exciting news out from the company. You and I, Ron, recently talking about the completion of phase one, and now phase two is getting underway at your Texas Critical Data Center. So let's remind everyone about the data center, and then what does phase two look like?
Yeah, so just a brief overview. So, you know, we've acquired 235 acres. We own and operate that through our joint venture with Sharon AI, so under Texas Critical Data Centers. We've also have an option to close an additional 203 acres that should be closed within 60, 90 days. We're just wrapping up some of the environmental studies, but that should close. So that's going to give us ultimately 438 acres. So again, ultimately what we're looking to do is scale this potentially up to, you know, 1 gigawatt and beyond. Basically, again, you know, really using what they call behind the meter power gen with the addition of the possibility of adding, you know, grid down the road. But right now, it's behind the meter power is kind of where it's at.
Yeah. And so what is phase two looking like? What kind of work are you doing in phase two?
Phase two is really under, like we're actually about to begin site clearing. I mean, we're looking at that, you know, runoff water, you know, storage, drain storage of that nature, you know, basically laying out, getting the acres cleared out for actually build, you know, getting it built ready. Additionally, you know, one thing that we're doing is we're also working with a engineering firm to actually design and build out a potential data center. So a lot of companies, we, you know, whether you look at powered land or powered shells, we're also looking at the opportunity to look at, you know, offering a powered shell opportunity. So essentially kind of just leasing out the data center, you know, to a hyperscaler. So again, that model versus kind of the powered land provides a more, I guess, constant revenue stream, as opposed to more of some of this chunky, you know, revenues versus the powered land side.
Will, are there ones that you've looked at or things that you've looked at that allows you to sort of make decisions a little quicker, knowing what some people have done and what you like and what you don't like? Are you able to glean some of that information from others?
Oh, absolutely. It's kind of like, why reinvent the wheel? So kind of look at what has transpired to date. What do we like? What do we do not like? Obviously for us, it's really speed to power, power to energy. And I think that's what our customers want. I mean, you know, if you look, I think the idea of connecting to the grid, you know, to just forget about being in Texas, forget about anywhere across the US, there's just massive demand for data centers. And so one thing that we can control is what they call behind the meter power generation. So that is where we basically, you know, control our destiny. And that's what we're doing.
Yeah. You're still on track for beginning construction around 2026. So obviously there's some due diligence work that has to be done over the next year, but at the beginning of 2026. So it's very quickly into construction is what I'm trying to get at.
Yeah, I think what we're looking forward to is really getting the site cleared. I mean, you look at it, it's still raw land at this stage in the game. And yeah. So we're working on, you know, various applications to include it as an industrial district within the city of Odessa. It does sit just outside the city limits. So we are in Ector County. But I think what's really important, you know, to how do you differentiate, you know, our data center from other data centers, and that's something we put in our recent press release, Steve, was we're in an attainment zone. So essentially what that means is we can actually go to 250 tons of emissions per year. So that's with your VOCs and your NOx and that nature. Whereas other areas that are in non-attainment or even non-attainment severe, you can even go, you know, maybe 50 or even 100. So that really limits the amount of power that you can deliver to a customer. So for instance, if you're in the DFW area, you're in a non-attainment severe zone, that's 50 megawatts. Hmm. So when you look versus where we're at on a, you know, in an attainment zone, that's 400 megawatts. So I think, you know, that's, and not to mention the permitting process is much, much quicker doing a minor source air permit versus a, what they call a major source air permit that may take 18, 24 months. So I think, yeah. There's a lot of little things that differentiate, you know, our specific data center campus relative to others. So you said, you know, again, but we looked at what had transpired in the past to understand how we want to build this one out.
Makes a lot of sense. And phase two underway. Will, thanks so much. Good update. Good to talk to you, and we'll see you again, okay?
All right, thanks, Steve. I appreciate it.
All right, Will Gray, the CEO of New Era Energy and Digital.